Here we go, box or case break. This is Panini Donruss Diamond Keens 12 box case break numero uno, number one. And here are the teams, the players, or the people with each team. And good luck to everyone. Thank you for everyone that bought in. This is a lot of cards. This is the first one I've seen of this. So this will be some fun stuff. I haven't seen this stuff in a little bit, so it's the first time I've seen it this year. So here we go. It's a lot of cards. I know that. This thing's massive. This thing is massive. Knives. Is anyone on? No one's chatting. No one's chatting. Let's just do a pack by pack for now until I figure out the flow of this good stuff. R2, what's up, dude? How you doing, man? Got Joey Votto, Braxton Garrett, Babe Ruth. That is a cool card. Dylan Carlson. Little Bo Bichette. That's cool. And Joey Bart debut. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. The packs on this even feels different than normal. Do you know there's some cool stuff in this stuff, though? Jose Ramirez, Bobby Delbecq, Cody, Jackie Robinson. I've always been a fan of this, just by the photos they do. It's always cool stuff. Ooh, Cody Bellinger. Cody Bellinger. Kind of a die-cut type thing. Ronald Acuña Jr., Jose Abreu.
is another thick one. Another thick one.
Brendan Lowe. Sounds good, Paul. Are you a big fan of Chisholm? Chisholm? A little jazz? Honestly, I didn't even look at the a little dud piece. I didn't even look at the checklist before this. I usually do. This kid hit two bombs, I think last night or two nights ago. I'm a big fan of him. I have some nice cards of him. Alejandro Kirk for the Toronto Blue Jays. He can hit. He can hit. That's for sure. Joey Bart, Mickey Cochran. That is a cool card. Nice. Tampa Bay. My handy dandy list to see who has who. Killebrew. Ryan Weathers. Ty Cobb. Look at that. How's it look on your end, video wise? Is it clear, focus wise? Because I was watching some of the YouTubes that we put up of, you know, our breaks, watching some film of us. And sometimes it's not always the clearest. Sometimes. I don't know if it was because of my service, like my cell service, or if it was the focus on the camera. But usually we do a pretty good job of making sure it's clear. Jamal Jones, Joe Cronin, Chris Pitino, Lou Gehrig. Little Roger Maris. Ryan Castellani. Yeah, these are definitely one I can rip all at once. A whole box at once. So after this box, I don't necessarily have to do it pack by pack. Vladdy Jr. Luis Gonzalez. Tatis. Mitchell Paige. Ted Williams, Luis Garcia, Grover Alexander. Shane Bieber, Monty Harris. And Greenberg, Tavares, little Mike Piazza, Stan Musial, Casey Mize. That's cool. Garrett Crochet, this gets good. Bueller, DJ LeMahieu, Tariq Skubal, Jonathan Stever. So there's what? Two autographs or memorabilia cards per box on average in these. So usually two hits per box. There can be some absolute monsters in here though. Like old school monsters. They're rare, but they're out there. William Contreras, Christian Yelich, Jesus,
Raphael Devers.
Francisco Lindor.
Tucker Davidson. Braylon Marquez.
For the Cubs.
For the Cubs.
There's some weird packs. Pete Rose.
Miggy. Brendan Marquez.
Joey Bart. That's a cool one.
Tom Seaver.
Just Speaker. That's weird.
So, we must have an autograph or something in it.
There we go.
For the Cubs,
Sixer. Braylon Marquez.
So this one goes to the Cubbies.
Braylon Marquez. He's got Cannon.
That's odd. So we only got the one jersey card. In that?
Odd.
That was the first box.
Maybe the other boxes, one of them will have three in them.
But we'll see. Here's box number two. Box number two.
Like its a little throne.
It's the king. Diamond king.
Chat is on fire today.
Here we go.
Patriots speaker. Brandon Lowe, Kevin Smith, Gilbert Ruiz, Johnny Bench, Joey Bart, Mickey Cochran. It's a cool picture. Louis Robert.
Ooh, look at this. A little artist proof.
To 149. You can see the serial on that.
Alex Bregman. Or no, this is out of 41 of 49.
Sorry about that. Artist proof. Jose Abreu. Brady Singer. Roberto Clemente. Andy Young. Joe DiMaggio. Ooh, nice. Jersey auto. Keegan Aiken out of 199 for the Orioles. Nice. Pete Alonso. Artist palette. Brady Singer. Joe Adell. Look at that.
Two color. Player one worn or and player worn or used.
We're not too sure.
Nice. The Angels. Ichiro, the club.
Alec Baum.
What on earth?
Ryan Mountcastle, Diamond King's debut. And Tim Anderson.
Thought we had like an error card at first. Nice.
Tristan Apostle. For the Rangers.
Tyler Stevenson.
Bo Bichette. Al Kaline, Mr. Tiger.
Christian Pache.
Tony Quinn.
Juan Soto.
And Edward Olivares.
Olivares. Varus. Can't ever say his name.
Jorge Mateo. The Padres.
Joe Jackson.
Casey Mize. Kim. This might be a bigger card than you think. This is like his true rookie, probably. Well, I guess it's Panini, but
he doesn't have any rookies. He's not Bowman yet. He signed for a massive deal
in the offseason, international
from Korea. Mookie Betts.
MLB debut, Diamond Kings, Tyler Stevenson. Kyle Lewis. Christian Javier.
Brain Hayes. And that's it for box number two.
Let's go with this box. Box number three. Box number three. Alrighty, box number three. Daniel Johnson. Wagner, Anderson Tejada, Jake Cronenworth. Ian Anderson for the Braves. William Contreras, Christian Yelich, pick these up the wrong way. Jake DeGrom, Verlander, Casey Mize, Kyle
Ripken, Al Kaline.
Dylan Carlson, Diamond Kings to the Cardinals. Jackie Robinson. Man, these are all flipped upside down. Abby Dalbec. There we go. Manny Machado. Nick Nieder. Shane McClanahan. Joey Bart.
Nick Madrigal auto. I like that. There's the White Sox. Tom. Congrats, Tom. That's awesome. That's a good one. Is it numbered? Nice. He's been playing well.
Christian Pache. Diaz. Last little stack. Luis Gonzalez, Fernando Tatis. Juan Soto. Rafael Devers. Chris Wagner. Vladdy.
Monty Harris, artist proof to 49. Rookie. For the Marlins, out of 49. Nice. I like the artist proof stamps. They're hard to see on camera, but in person they're really cool.
Box. All right, here we go. Next box. I think this is box number 4. Box number 4. I need to stream my Instagram. I need to get some talkers. And then we would get some chat going. Packs, man, they're weird. They tear in all different ways.
Made the packs look all cool, but man, they tear weird.
I saw the auto, accidentally pulled it. So we'll start off with that. A little Tariq Skubal for the Detroit Tigers. Nice. Southpaw. Young kid. Oh, and it's out of 50. Nice. 21 out of 50. This kid's going to be good. He throws some heat. He throws some heat, that's for sure. Watch out. William Contreras, jersey. This one's actually out of 99. You can see that. There you go. Keibert Ruiz, cut out. Die cut type thing. Ricky Henderson. Yogi Berra. Brady Singer. Ooh, nice. Isaac Paredes. Joe DiMaggio. Nate Pearson. Luke Brock. Anthony Rendon. See a redemption. Chris Bryant, which we already pulled the auto. We pulled the auto and the jersey, and we're about to have a redemption. Huh. Anderson Tejada, Jake Cronenworth, Grant Hayes. I think it was a redemption. Freddie Freeman, Daniel Jones, Trevor Story. Maybe I'm seeing things. Alex Kirloff, Joe Wood, Walter Johnson. Huh. Maybe I'm seeing things. Bo Bichette. Manny Machado. That is awesome. Jackie Robinson, cutout, die cut type thing. That is cool. I like that. Cal Ripken. Casey Mize. Kim. Juan Soto. Carl Hubel, Joe Adell, Tristan McKenzie, Mickey Cochran, Luis Robert, Spencer Howard, Fernando Tatis. Oh, that's cool. Tanner Houck, he's pitching tonight. I don't know how he's doing, but. I didn't see a redemption. Maybe I wanted to see the redemption. All right. Here we go, next box.
we got on? Let's see here. We got 9 people on at least. I'm sure Grizz is in the background. What else we got? What else we got in this break? We got Noah, we got Paul, Scott, Mark, Jerry, Guy Webster. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. I need to start bringing people from my Instagram over. Because I have quite a bit of buddies on Instagram that when I open stuff, I usually go on there. And it's fun. A lot of dialogue, talk to different players, all that good stuff. So what I need to do is set up something where I'm streaming to both. I did it for Bowman yesterday for the first time. Went well. It's just hard with 2 cameras. So I'll probably be streaming more on Instagram moving forward. Spencer Howard auto. I'm a diehard Tigers fan. Diehard Tigers fan. I worked for the Tigers for about 7 years, Diamondbacks for a year, the Reds for a year. Diehard Tigers fan. Oh yeah, Paul? Oh yeah. I used to help out, I was in the clubhouse, so I used to take, I started off in AAA with the Toledo Mudhens. Oh, okay, Warren, Michigan, nice. I'm from Toledo, Ohio. I say Toledo, Ohio, but in the middle of nowhere, Toledo, out in the burbs, out in farmland, but... Oh, yeah. Yep.
good buddies with Miggy. When I was there, Avisel Garcia, Joe Jackson. Good buddies with him. Satchel Paige. Brian Villarreal, Jose Ortega, Victor Martinez, Evan White. Oh, yeah? Jacoby Jones? Nice. He came around after I was gone. After I was gone. He's good, though. Defensively, he's phenomenal. I wish he could hit a little bit better, but Kevin Smith. Chris Bryant. Yeah. Are you a Lions fan, Paul? Paul, you'd probably love this. So one Christmas, Miguel Cabrera gave me a 2007 game used. Miguel Cabrera gave me a 2007 game used All-Star jersey. It's when they were in Pittsburgh, and the whole NL team, signed it, which was pretty cool, because he was still on the Marlins at the time, in 17 or in 07. In 2007. Oh yeah, Maglio gave me a 2006 World Series ring or American League Championship ring, which was cool. I wasn't there in 06, but. He gave me one of his, one of the family ones. They give him one really nice one to keep. Nice where they wear it for special occasions. Then they give him, an everyday one, and family ones. He gave me one of the American League Championship, which still has, all the diamonds. Oh, yeah, I'm a diehard Lions fan, Paul. I'm diehard Detroit everything. Season tickets and everything, even though I live down here. Al Kaline, I used to eat breakfast with him every morning. Sad that he passed away. I used to eat breakfast with him every morning. Frosted Flakes. And Torrey Hunter when he was there. It was always us three. It wasn't an exciting draft, but I think we did great. I think we did great. I'd rather have that than draft a bunch of flashy guys that, I think what we're going to do, could have, but he's not, you need to protect Goff and all that. Goff, you can find receivers in free agencies and late in the draft. I actually would have been pretty mad if we drafted a receiver. I'd rather have the staple guy. I think Smith's going to be good. If he would have went on the Lions, he would have been just like Kelvin Johnson, Roy Williams, all that other stuff where, he's dominant, but the rest of the team is garbage and can't win any games. So, yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of golf, but honestly, I think that's good because we got him. We got some staples, some young kids coming in. See what they can do, and then that'll give us a good draft pick. Next year and probably the year after that, and then we can go get a quarterback then. Instead of getting a good quarterback now, just like how we did with Stafford, and they get demolished. He basically wasted his career away in Detroit. Because we couldn't build around them. I'd rather build around first, and then at the right time, once you get everything else in place, that's when you bring the quarterback in. Mel Ott out of 49. Artist proof. Because when you get him on that QB rookie deal, you save a lot of cap space. So if you can build around him, build around him and then
once your team's ready, all you need is a good quarterback. You bring someone in like that on a rookie deal, and you can spend your money on position players. Pee Wee Reese, just like how the Dolphins did. I love what the Dolphins did. They're going to be good this year. Everyone's down on Tua, but he's not going to have to do much for them to win games and get to the playoffs. The defense, and they'll give him some weapons, and but he, you know, they're not going to ask him to do too much, like carry the team. That's why Mahomes is so successful. Obviously, he's a freak, but if you put him on a different team, a different system, you know, they're not winning Super Bowls and stuff. Lou Gehrig? Yeah. I think it's going to be a long season. Evan White? I pull more of this guy than anyone, I bet. Evan White? Yeah, Swift and Hockenson. I mean, Goff can't throw it down the field anyway, so he throws slants. Like, he's a quick, he throws slants and all that, so it's not even worth getting a good receiving core, because you can get anyone to run slants. Etrio. Kurloff, Joe Wood, Bellinger. I think the Cyphus, the kid from Wisconsin, rookie this year, I think he's going to be good. I forget his actual name. I don't even know how to start with this name. Kohi Harahara? Yogi Berra? Paul, you'll like this. So there's a group of us that all own one. Ooh, look at this. Another auto of Nick Madrigal to 99. Going to Tom. That's odd. Two Madrigal autos. The same case. Jimbo and Paul. I was receiver in high school, believe it or not. Every time I caught a pass, I just tried to run as fast as I could out of bounds. Justin, are you here? Didn't even know he came in. Joe Adell. Mr. Tiger himself. Man, hearing his stories was a lot of fun. Jorge Mateo, Joe Jackson. Tyler Stevenson. Play DB. Nice. Paul, I really wanted the Lions draft Nico Collins, Christy Matheson. I think he's going to be a nice little sleeper. Tyler Stevenson. Joey Bart on a 99 jersey bat. Randy Arozarena. Eddie Stinky Leg. But I'm interested to see this year how we do as Lions. You know, I don't have, you know, a ton of faith in Jared Goff, which is fine. Because it's not like we're going to the Super Bowl anyways, no matter what. So it's like, let's just see who we have, talent-wise, young guys. See who shows up. Evaluate them. See who we need to get rid of and who we need to keep. And then build on from there. So. I like our coach, though. I like your coaching staff. I like our GM as of right now. Obviously, we don't know until down the line, but what he did with the Rams, I mean, they built that team up pretty good.
Yeah, we are, Paul. Honestly,
the most fun I've had as a season ticket holder are times when we're not very good. Because it's, you know, the stadium's usually empty and, you know, we're not really expecting to win anyway. So when we do win, we go nuts. Like, we go after, like, every time we win, it feels like a Super Bowl because we're not supposed to win any game. So, I look at it like that.
But it's cool. There's about 30 to 40 of us that we all own one season ticket. They're all the seats are together. And we don't go to every game because obviously I live down here. You know, everyone kind of, it's whatever. But we have like, we put all the tickets in a pool. So like, let's say I can't go to a lot of the games. You know, other people can use it and they don't have to ask me. It's kind of just like a community ticket pool. And like if they want to bring friends or family or whatnot, whatever it is, you know, there's always tickets available. For that, but we all, like, everyone sits together, so it's a lot of fun. I love that we do it. We tailgate every single game, in the same spot, right across from, the anchor. Yeah, the anchor. We have our own little spot. It's a pretty cool setup that we do. We've been doing it for years where they know to save our spot, and there's other people that tailgate around us that we know, and just a good time.
Little time.
One soda. Oh, that's cool. Keith Hernandez. Bat. Every time I see that. See Keith Hernandez, I think of Seinfeld. Oh, wow. Yeah, Paul. That's awesome. Next time I go to a game, I need to let you know where we hang out at and all that. It's a lot of fun. Like, we have a huge crew. We take the mugger mover over. Everything. I used to live in downtown for a while with some of the guys, some of the players, Tigers. They all stay at the same apartment complex type thing, hotel/apartment. I wouldn't even know how to call it. Right in downtown. Oh yeah, same three, but that's awesome. Yeah. It's funny, man, like the Lions, we're not very good, but we probably have one of the most, I would say us in Cleveland, very loyal fan bases. Very loyal. Hey, Pearson. Yogi Bear. I have a group of, like, there's, you know, I have a group of, like, a text message group. We call it Lions Nation. And it's probably what I'm talked to the most in, for texts. We're nonstop talking about prospects, players, all that. All year round. It's funny because we all have like wildly different opinions too on players and stuff. And strategy of creating the team. What you doing over there, Justin? Extremely loyal. Yeah. Yeah, Paul. I agree. I think more long term, like, because I got to, when I was in baseball for a while, like, I got to. Ooh, nice. Tristan McKenzie. I like this kid a lot. I think he is going to be solid. Really solid. For the Indians. When I was with the Tigers and stuff, I got to be like in the war room for
draft, like for the draft and all that, like talk to the GMs and scouts all the time. And it's funny, like, you know, once you get into that, like you really see the thought process as a whole, like with salary cap and, you know, just because you have a good player doesn't mean, you know, nice. Will Crow? Yeah, they were fun. It was a good time. I probably shouldn't have ever left, but it's all good. Christy Matheson. Ken Griffey Jr. Nothing beats Tigers baseball. I love all Detroit Tigers sport, or all Detroit sports, but I'm a baseball guy through it all. Like, that's my thing. Baseball. Prospects. I watch reruns, like replays of games in the offseason nonstop. I watch the Caribbean League. I watch Korea League. I watch minor league games all the time. It's awesome. It's awesome. That's what makes, I think, baseball card investing is probably one of the easiest things ever. So obvious who's gonna, like, so obvious, obviously easy to make money on some of these guys. It's like the same trend over and over on who, what guys are gonna be more valuable. And I love that part. It's fun. But I'm a collector at heart. Time for me time. Yeah. Time's long. So Warren, Michigan. What do you like? Do you like Sparty, or do you like U of M, or different team? Chippewas. Who else are up there? I'll tell you what, though, the West Michigan is a great place to watch a game. When I was with the Diamondbacks, I was with the South Bend Silverhawks, and we would play the Western Michigan a lot. Grizzlies guy. Oh. Grizzlies, is that Oakland? Grizzly Oakland? College West? Oakland Bears, right? Or yeah, I guess Oakland Grizzlies. Who's your favorite player of all time? Any sport, like basketball or baseball or football, or really any sport. Like, do you have an all-time favorite? Oh, really? Ricky Henderson. Okay. Yeah, Calvin Johnson, man. I don't think people really realize how good he really was. Mookie Betts. The Lions were absolutely horrible when Calvin Johnson was there. And the quarterback carousel, you know, obviously he got Stafford there at the end, like Piazza. But man, some of the quarterbacks he had before, Dalton, and Stafford had a lot of injuries in the beginning of his career. But they, Sixto Sanchez rookie, like teams knew, ooh, this is nice. Havin Smith auto jersey. This is a nice card. First rounder for the Diamondbacks. He's playing well. He's playing really well for the Diamondbacks. And, but teams knew all we had was, there you go, Josh Chisholm.
Oh, wow.
Every game. They got a pretty good basketball team, if I remember right. Or program. They usually do. Pete Alonso.
I need to check that out. I've never been to an Oakland game. Yogi Berra? Pete Alonso? They used to play Toledo every so often, I feel like. Christian Javier? My uncle's a huge Toledo Rockets booster. Like, he travels with the teams to go to games and stuff. Puts them on the bench and all that fancy stuff. Satchel Paige. Nick Madrigal. Oh, wow. I didn't know that. Is there some kind of connection for it? Because I feel like that's kind of random. Oakland. For Jordan to go there. Because I know they're pretty strict on who they sign with. Speaker. Well, actually, I have a Detroit Tigers shirt on right now. I didn't even realize. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Drew Rosman. Look at this card coming up. You'll like this. Spencer Howard. George Sizzler, Roberto Clemente. Look at that. Two color, Phil Niekro jersey. Oh, that makes sense. That's awesome.
LeBron James.
Growing up around there, I remember LeBron in high school. We'd be going to his games in high school. We knew he was going to be good, but I can't lie, I didn't know he was going to be this good. Oh, that's awesome. That'd be cool, yeah, to be there when he was there, because I'm sure it's a smaller stadium, too, so you can probably be pretty close to him. Vladdy? He's one athlete I haven't met that I would really want to meet. I know it's really hard to meet him, because he has a pretty close circle around him that he doesn't let people. Oh, I gotta check that out. Look this up. Here we go. Just lift it up. It's pretty cool.
Dude, that's nuts. I did not know they were Jordan brand. That's cool. I personally like the smaller gyms. Like Toledo, they redid their gym. And they took out a lot of seats. Like, they totally reconstructed the stadium. And they took out a ton of seats. And they made it, like, better to watch the game. And I was all for it. Now it's a great place to watch a game. No matter what seat, you know, you can't have a bad seat. I prefer that all day. I don't want to go to a game where, you know, I pay all this money and I sit up in the rafters and I can't see anything. Like, I'd rather watch it on TV then. I also don't want to pay tons of money to be right on courtside. Ricky Hayes. Man, he was a lot of fun to watch. Packs.
Esteban.
Yeah. The chat is usually
not very active for this account. Albert Pujols. It's a rat though.
Kirby Puckett.
Man, he's fun to watch too.
I do a lot of stuff on other social medias. That's one thing
that I'm going to be implementing here is us to do that, like a lot of different other stuff, kind of get more engagement and having fun with talking cards and all that good stuff. Favorite MLB NFL player of all time. For baseball, it was always Ivan Rodriguez growing up. Always. But then I got to know Miggy really well as a person and got to, you know, be with, I was basically hanging out with him a lot and got to see him play a lot. And man, no, I think it's Miggy now, honestly. He's such a good guy in general. Blake Snell. George Brett. Miggy's probably one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet. Most down to earth. Absolutely loves the game. Loves the game. He just wants to play. It sucks seeing him hurt all the time because I know how much he wants to just be out there and play. But he can't. Down in spring training one year, I remember we were, you know, we were in Lakeland. And we had a game in Jupiter, which is a pretty far drive. And a lot of the starters, you know, like the main MLB guys don't travel to those games. They'll stay at the facility and, you know, play on the backfields. Oh, he's a huge jokester.
And I remember Miggy rolled up because usually we take a bus, but some of the MLB guys, they'll drive on their own. I said, Miggy, what are you doing here, dude? He's like, I want to play baseball. I was like, all right, cool. He'd be like the only guy, MLB player, on a lot of the away games. Joey Bart. Braylon Marquez to 99 for the Cubbies. That's the second one of him, too. And this was after, like, his triple crown year and everything. Like, he had nothing to prove. He just loves the game. Loves it. He used to send me, like, tons of gear. Like, cleats. Like, random New Balance shirts. Like, boxes to my house. Because he thought it was funny. Because my fiance now, who's now my fiance, she'd be like, what are we going to do with all this? We don't even know where to put any of it. To 49, Nate Pearson, artist proof. That's a nice one. And he did it because he thought it was funny. Ronald Acuña Jr. Joe Morgan. Oh, Paul, it was the best. Honestly, it was the best. Honestly, he's the best hitter I've ever seen. And I've seen Trout close up. Trout's a freak, too. I'm a fan of Trout, what he can do. Ryan Sandberg. Rhino. Ooh, this is awesome. Eddie Collins. But Miggy might be one of the most pure hitters of all time. Doesn't matter what you throw him, he'll just take what you give him, and you know, he'll hurt you with it. He'll hit oppo, he'll pull it. He'll just poke it. Like, he's just a pure hitter. Ryan Greenberg, or Hank Greenberg. I'm a big fan of Hank Greenberg. Maddox, Alec Baum, Nate Pearson. All right, next box. Let me check this out real quick, though. Let's see if we got some of this other stuff filled. Last three boxes. Paul, are you a basketball fan? Like, NBA? Pistons fan? Man, when we were good back in, what was it, 03? That was so much fun. That was so much fun. I was always a huge Big Ben fan. Ben Wallace. The real Big Ben. Oh yeah, Paul? I've been getting really into UFC lately, actually. I used to watch a lot when I was younger, but then I stopped for a while, and then I'm back into it now. I watch reruns of fights all the time, and I've been buying a ton of UFC cards within the last year or two. And the fact that Prism came out,
UFC Prism,
got me pumped. And I don't know if you've seen Bad Boys for Life. Yeah, but Bad Boys. I don't know if you've seen any of that Prism stuff ripped. Prism UFC. But it is so good. UFC on right now.
Yeah.
The UFC Prism that they pulled out, or they put out for us, is so good. Throughout the board, like, not just what we have, but, like, I've seen other people break it. That's how I usually, you know, I watch a lot before I buy anything or think that something's good, to get a real opinion on it, to see it as holistically. And there's so much value in there. They put so much color, and they didn't make a lot of it, which I know for a fact that they didn't. So there's not a lot of it out there. So I think it's going to boom in price. Shane Bieber. Nice. Yeah, I got one in last night. I got one Prism box in last night. I know we have some here. But I'm probably going to rip a few on my own. For the personal collection. Babe Ruth. That's a cool car. I've ripped a ton of that Top Striking. I think that stuff is a great deal too. You know, it was at like $35 and then jumped to $75. But honestly, you know, that stuff I have a feeling is going to skyrocket. Yeah, it is expensive. Prism. I think it's worth it. In my opinion. I think it's worth it to even rip it. I usually tell people, don't rip it, hold it. But that's actually something where if you rip it, you're going to get good value out of it. Ryan Jeffers. Look at that patch. To 50. That is a cool patch. Three color. Yeah, me too, Paul. Me too. I ripped like probably a total of 10 cases. I was like, $35 all day, dude. Keep sending them. Keep sending them. You should see how many boxes we have here. How many cases? We have tons. I was like, let's buy as much as that as we can and hold on to it. You know, we can put it on the site for people, but ooh, this is nice. Alec Baum auto. Going to Noah Hendricks. Shocker. He's been on a heater. Man. Yeah, Paul. I agree. It's funny because before I started officially working with Kentucky Roadshow, I bought them out. I bought everything they had. When is that $35 a box? And then it jumped up in price like a week after Roberto Clemente. And they were like, man, you bought us out. I was like, yeah, I knew it was going to jump. I feel like if you watch the trends and watch the product and see people's reactions, and if you can tell pretty quickly when a product's going to jump like that in price. You can tell pretty quickly. I think this Chronicle stuff, Football Chronicles, is a good buy right now too, what I've seen. I don't know about Bowman this year. I don't know if that's going to go up or not. I don't think it will. It's a good set and everything, but I don't know if it's going to have that. Bowman's my favorite. I got in the last break with you guys. Got to raise autograph. He's fighting. Oh, no way. Yeah. My last name is Reyes. That's awesome. Yeah, I forgot he's fighting tonight. This is nice. Pretty sure that's a short print. That is really nice. That is an awesome card. If it's not a short print, that is still an awesome card regardless. There you go, Grizz. I know you're probably in the background waiting for Brian to get on, but that is an awesome card. Congrats. Oh, yeah. Honestly, I forgot it was Saturday. I've been here
this week. I'm forgetting my days. I might open some striking tonight for myself. Casey Mize, Kim, Luis Robert, that's nice. Oh, there you go. Jazz. Medina. Braxton Garrett. Nice ball. Paul, we have some top striking UFC if you wanted any. I think, yeah, that's what I usually do when I'm at home too. But we have top striking. I think we have them at 75 a box. I don't know if we have them listed on the site, but if you wanted any, I'm sure we can put some on for you. But only if you want. Just offering it. We also have Prism UFC, but you're right. Like, that stuff is, it is expensive. It's very expensive. Black and Gold, what's up? Got another person in. It's been quiet. Paul and I. It's good. Paul and I have been talking. Another Detroit person, which I'm a big fan of. This is Diamond Keen's number one. And we're about done with it. Case break number one. I like this stuff. You know, this stuff you won't hit. Well, actually, there are like huge hitters in here, like some ultra rare, like Babe Ruth stuff, which is really hard to get, really hard to hit. But other than that, like the photos on these cards and stuff, like it's a cool product. They do well on this, like the looks of it. I think it's some great PC stuff. Oh, Paul, that's awesome. Yeah, that's a steal, $900 a box. Yeah, that's good. Awesome. Man, I wish I could stand it for 900. Yeah, me too, Black and Gold. They do well with this. Like, they overall, it's a good looking product. You know, you pay for what you get for the, like, the resale value, I feel like. But, I mean, you could hit a monster card in here. It's ultra rare, but. I bet, Paul. I know if I had them at that price, I mean, I wouldn't be able to. There's no way I would be wanting to rip them at $900. If they were $900 on our site, I'd be ripping every one we had myself. Yeah, I agree, Black and Gold. Just something about like this. Like, that is just a cool card. Aficionado. I'm a vintage guy too, though, so that's probably why I like this stuff. It has like that vintage feel. Vintage players. There you go. There you go, Paul. That's a nice card. That's awesome, Paul. Do you have a favorite fighter? Itrio. Cronenworth? Max Holloway? Oh, yeah. Max Holloway, he's a fun one to watch.
I feel like UFC is just, wow, look at this. This is cool.
One of one. Christy Mathison. That is a beauty. That is really cool. Gallery of Stars.
That is really cool. I'm going to get that sleeved up.
That is cool.
I'm a fan of this card.
I don't know how excited I was to get like a one-of-one of like this kind. It would still be cool, but the fact that it's like this, this is just a cool-looking card.
For New York.
That is beautiful. That is cool. I know.
Isn't that nuts?
I mean, really, it basically was a cardigan. Look at the little pockets.
That's cool.
Like this card, too. Look at that. This one's cool. Like, I would love a one-of-one of that.
The inserts on these are cool.
Like, if it was a one-on-one of something like this, I'd be like, oh, that's cool. But the fact that it was a
old-school player,
I guess I'd want one like of this, too, though. Lou Gehrig.
Bobichet. Nice.
Jones. Big Papi. Biggie. There's like a silver hollow refractor of something.
We haven't had any of those yet.
Ooh, look at this. I forgot these were in here. Wow. That is cool. And it's clean. Wow. That is cool. Downtown. Who has the Dodgers? Arturo, congrats, my friend. This is awesome.
Wow, this was a great box. The 101 and the downtown. Let me get this sleeved up for you.
That is a beauty. Congrats.
They look really cool in person. Like, this one is clean. Like, gradable clean. That is beautiful. Reggie Jackson?
There it is. Miggy. The Art of Hitting. Yep, I like this card. I will be buying some base of this one.
Or the PC.
Lad.
Will Crow auto out of 99 for the Pittsburgh Pirates.
Nice.
Nice.
Little Shohei Ohtani.
Dude, look at this.
This design is awesome. By the way, it's the 101.
Christy Matthews.
It's like, if it was, I was saying, like,
oh, look at that Bellinger, huh?
Yeah. Like, if it was one of these and it was a 101, I'd be like, ah, it's whatnot. But the fact that it's that cool insert. Ooh, that's cool view.
Casey Mize rookie
for our Detroit Tigers. Eddie Stanky leg.
Stanky.
Lou Gehrig.
This has been good stuff.
I knew it.
What'd you know? Brian's here, by the way, everyone.
The wrong microphone is on.
Really?
Uh-huh.
This entire time?
Since last night. I was listening to the video, so I was like, what the
Oh, there's an echo?
Yeah, it was pretty brutal. Boom.
Is it better now?
I don't know. It will be.
Paul, is it a lot better right now? Paul and I have been talking. He's a big Detroit Tiger fan. Well, Detroit everything.
Yeah.
You've been...
Is this the first one? Or...
Yep.
These take so long, don't they?
Yeah. I've been going a little bit slower than usual because...
What are these five over here?
Well, I accidentally grabbed them out, and then I realized there was a full case break because I thought it was maybe a half case, so then I went to go get this. So I just need to put them back.
Okay.
They were loose ones.
Oh, okay. I know what you're saying now. Those came from GTS.
Yeah. At first, when I pulled the big box, like the case with both of them, I was like, dude, this is so many cards. And then I opened it, realized it was two cases in one.
Yeah.
I was like, okay. Whew.
A master case with two 12-case inners makes no sense to me, but whatever.
Yeah.
I mean.
Joe Adell.
Just a box holder.
Yeah. So is it a lot better now, Paul? Is it too loud or is it perfect or... Because on my mic, I have it. I can turn it up or down. Last box.
Really good noises.
Nice.
What's up, Paul?
Sounds really good now. Almost as good as Ernie Bank or Ernie Harwell. Beans. We have a lot of breaks tonight. That's why I came in earlier. Do people like it if we start a little bit earlier? Like if we have one full already, like we start at 7:38-ish to get it started? Because I know when I break, I like to get on around 7. Feel like that's right, you know, for East Coast people. I know for West Coast, it's probably better for 9 East Coast time. But I feel like 7 is a lot. We'll probably be doing that more often. Because I can be here during that time. I know Brian usually comes in around 9 after kids are in. Kids are all settled up. East Coast, best coast. Yeah, you're right. I've lived on the east side most of my life. Lived in Arizona for a little bit. That's about it on the west side of the country. East Coast, best coast. Last box, here we go. Trey Turner. He's a card collector. Jones. Second one of those of his. Yogi Berra. Altuve. Kim. A Rosarena. Chris Bryant. Yeah. Bregman, William Contreras, Manny Machado, oh. Pee Wee Reese. Bob Gibson. Nice. Ian Anderson auto for the Braves. That's good solid. Rod Carew. I like the sound of that sorting. Nick Niedert for the Miami Marlins. Babe Ruth, the Big Bambino. Albert Pujols. He was a lot of fun to watch back in the day. Dalvik. Nice. Cody Mize. Diamond Kings. So many cards.
When you think Diamond Kings, do you think, oh my god, it's going to be this many cards?
Yeah, I do, because
it seems like it'd be a little break.
Yeah. It's going to be a long sort. There's a lot of them. Joey Bart, Mickey. The Polar Bear, Christian Javier, Eddie Stinky Leg. Which, what is he sorting right now?
Hoops.
Nice.
Yeah, hoops.
Cool beans. Get that one squared away, because we probably have what?
He was going to do that Bowman that was on the table. Told him to go back through all of it and make sure all the cards were in the right spot, because he didn't do it. So he doesn't have the memory of knowing what went where. But I think he's just going to sit the hoops.
Yeah, that's probably best. Alrighty, well, that was our break. Here's some of the highlights. Cody Bellinger, downtown, which was awesome. And Christy Mathison, 101. Let me pull out some of these autos and jerseys. I need to sleeve these bad boys up.
Did you hear it too?
Yep. Is that what he's listening to again?
It's like poison.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not a bad song. At all. I don't know who sings that.
Zombie.
So that one's a beast, huh?
Yeah, it was a biggie.
Christy Matthews, though.
Yeah, that's nice. And I'm pretty sure this is a short print, but I'm not completely sure.
Yeah, we gotta look at the checklist. There seems like they do something new every year, so.
Yeah. But it was the only one I saw, so I was like, huh. Of this kind. So that's usually a sign.
Yeah, that's a pretty good giveaway.
Alrighty, here, we got them all. I won't go through like the cutout, die cut ones, just because there's a lot of them.
The frames?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Out of 99, Keegan Aiken, Joe Adell, Ian Anderson, Nick Madrigal, the first one. Yeah, we hit two Nick Madrigal autos, jerseys. Ryan Jeffers to 50. Nice patch. Alec Baum auto. Nice. Tariq Skubal. William Contreras. Spencer Howard. Joey Bart. Nick Madrigal to 99, the second one. Joey Bart to 99. Keith Hernandez bat. Tristan McKenzie. Pavin Smith. Phil Negro. Nice. Two color.
Knuckleballer.
Yeah.
How old was he when he retired? Like 600?
He was pretty old. To 99. The Rhino. Pinstripe. Will Crow to 99 for the Pirates. Stan Musial. That's really nice. I like that. I like what jersey they did. Ian Anderson. And Nick Nieder. And that was our break. The first case, number one, Diamond Kings, full case break. And we will get all of this out to y'all. Thank you very much.